come this November, Portland residents will decide whether they want to elect a mayor for a four-year term or keep the tradition of appointing a mayor every year. The debate on this issue heats up today as each side tries to make their case to voters. News 8's Cam Tran is live at City Hall with the update in our Commitment 2010 coverage tonight. Cam?
Well, Heather Tracy, the Portland Charter Commission recommended this summer the city transition from an appointed mayor to an elected one, but not everyone feels that same way, and that's why those on both sides of this hot topic issue held press conferences today at City Hall.
An enthusiasm to defeat this.
Chanting and cheering ring along Congress Street as a small group against electing a mayor gathers in front of City Hall. They explain their reasons one by one.
Number one, the salary. Number two, it's another layer of bureaucracy. Number three, it's a ceremonial position with no powers. And number four, we have grave concerns about the ranked choice voting.
This group shoots down the Portland Charter Commission's recommendations to go from an appointed mayor to an elected one. They don't agree with the commission's proposal, which cites the mayor work full-time, serve 4 years, and earn a salary of $67,000 a year.
The money, we don't have the money. We need money to pay firemen, policemen, and the teachers, which they have been laying off.
But proponents to elect a mayor say that's not true.
Assertions that an elected mayor will cost the city more are off base.
Those in favor of a voted leader say the council could cut an assistant city manager position, a move that could cover the cost of an elected mayor.
As of this moment, we pay an assistant city manager approximately $94,000 a year to lead our legislative and economic development efforts. These are precisely the functions that an elected mayor will be carrying out. The elected mayor will do it far more effectively and far more cost effectively.
In addition, these activists assert having a full-time leader versus a part-time one is critical for Portland.
It's a scramble for them to keep up with two jobs. And so you don't have the continuity of political presence around the city that a city of this size and complexity deserves.
And this is what the question looks like on a sample ballot. As you can see, it's pretty lengthy here. It actually outlines the duties and powers of an elected mayor. If you want to take a look at this for yourself, you can go to our website, WMTW.com. Live in Portland, Cam Tran, News 8.